You've probably seen some of the beautiful, custom iPhone home screens that go viral on social media. After all, you open your phone and look at your home screen dozens, if not hundreds of times every day, so a personal home screen that matches your aesthetic can bring a little spark of joy to your daily life. I'm going to show you the new features that are upcoming in iOS 18, how you can go above and beyond with custom icons made with shortcuts, and how you can top off your look with widgets. I've scoured the internet, mostly Reddit, for the finest examples. iOS 18, which is available now as a developer beta, if you're so daring, opens up loads of customization options. For one, you can switch from light icons to dark icons, or to tinted icons, which adopt any color of your choosing. However, bear in mind that the tinted icons still use dark backgrounds, which means that these will work best if you have a similar, dark, moody wallpaper with a strong accent color. If you're already running iOS 18, just tap and hold on the home screen to enter jiggle mode. Tap Edit in the upper left, then tap Customize. You can pick between automatic, light, dark, or tinted. And from here, you can use the sliders to find a color you want, or you can use the eyedropper tool on the right to pick a specific color out of your wallpaper. And if you want, you can also tap the sun button on the left to darken your wallpaper a little more. Also, if you want a good, unobstructed view of your wallpaper, you can move the apps and folders to the bottom of the screen for the first time, giving you easy access with one hand. So Apple's built-in options are really easy to set up, but they are somewhat limited. The dark, tinted icons will clash if you want a lighter color scheme. If you want pastel colors like light pink, lavender, or aqua blue, you're going to need to go the next level and make custom icons. Ever since these custom home screens first went viral in 2020, loads of people have been making custom icon packs for the iPhone. The website I go to is called icons8.com. They have loads of different theme packs. You just tap on one, and then you can search for the icons you need, like YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. You'll see the results, and it's really easy to add these to your photo library. Custom icons don't always need to be about changing the color scheme. This one, for example, is just as colorful as Apple's own, but it changes the aesthetic to one with gentle colors and soft shadows. And this one goes in the complete opposite direction, styled like Windows 95. I'm actually using custom icons on my personal home screen, but in a little more of a subtle way. I'm using the regular iOS 18 dark mode icons because I still like having the color differentiation. But for the three third-party apps on my home screen, Snapchat, Mona, and NetNewsWire, they obviously haven't been updated for iOS 18 yet since it was just announced as a beta like 2 weeks ago. So I made my own custom icons to fit in with Apple's dark color scheme. To swap out the stock icons for your custom ones, here's what you need to do. You'll open the Shortcuts app, tap the plus in the upper right corner, then you'll tap Open App, and you'll select the app that you want to open. That's all the shortcut has to do. Now you'll tap the Share button in the bottom toolbar and tap Add to Home Screen. Now here comes the important part. You'll type in the label you want to give it, and then you'll tap the icon on the left and tap Choose from Photos. Here you actually pick the custom icon you want to use, and then you tap Add in the upper right. Now you have your custom app launcher on the home screen. To remove the old one, just tap and hold on an icon, tap Remove App, and then Remove from Home Screen, and you can move the new icon in its place. You'll have to repeat this process for every custom icon you want to make, which can be annoying if you have a lot of icons in your home screen, but the end results will be worth it. Now there is one thing to note about this kind of setup. Whereas Apple's built-in features will change the colors of your app icons across the system, this feature will only change them on the home screen. The icons will be unaffected in their appearance in the app library. That's because you're not really changing the icons, you're just creating a new icon for the home screen. Now, this customization hack does come with two unfortunate side effects. First, you won't see any notification badges on the icon anymore. And secondly, every time you tap on the icon, you'll see an annoying banner on the top of the screen reminding you that you just ran a shortcut, which unfortunately cannot be turned off even in iOS 18. Finally, you can enhance the look of your home screen with custom widgets. Apple's built-in widgets are very functional and utilitarian, but not necessarily beautiful. Using the tinted color scheme, they'll adopt whatever colors you use for your app icons, but the results still may not look ideal. Using an app like the viral sensation Widgetsmith, you can combine all of these three tips together to really elevate your aesthetic. The sky is the limit. You can add a calendar widget, weather widget, countdown widget, or a photo widget that does nothing except look good. And with the plethora of customization options for fonts and colors, you will be able to match any style you want. Stephen Hackett, the managing director of Widgetsmith, said to me over email, "With new tools coming in iOS 18, people will be able to more easily create their own unique aesthetic." Widgetsmith is updated very regularly to adopt all the latest iOS features, like widget interactivity, and with new color schemes every few months to inspire you. Stephen also told me that when users update to iOS 18 this fall, they'll be able to customize Control Center with third-party widgets made with Widgetsmith as well. You can download it from the App Store. It's available with a subscription for $1.99 a month or $19.99 a year. To see even more of what's possible, I recommend you subscribe to the free Cult of Mac Today newsletter. Every day in your email inbox, you'll get a really cool iPhone wallpaper ready for you to download. In addition to all the day's top Apple news, reviews, and how-tos, and my personal favorite part of the newsletter, the weird musings and anecdotes from our editor-in-chief, Leander Canny. You can click here to subscribe or in the link in the video description. Remember to like and subscribe. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.